The years of 1730 to 1850 were tumultuous years in Europe. They changed the course of human history. Great machines filled the skies with the smoke of progress, and historic leaders charged onto battlefields with banners flying. Now, more and more people were going to school. This worried the aristocracy.
Whatever shall we do? The scum of our cities are now learning to speak for themselves.
Soon, they will infiltrate the government, and therefore those of us with pure blood will be threatened.
They should be worried indeed. Their time in power is drawing to a close because of larger numbers of lower classes becoming educated.
There are also many more of them now. Curse good nutrition.
And now that there are so many, perhaps we will lose our control over them. We had better tighten our control over them pronto.
With a much larger population, there was soon a much larger workforce. Now large factories began to spring up. This worried some artisans and workers, as they thought this new boom would ruin their old way of life. In France, fighting broke out. Many aristocrats and members of the royal family and their followers were killed. After many years, Napoleon Bonaparte rose out of the chaos to unite a troubled kingdom. I, Napoleon, proclaim myself the Emperor of France. Napoleon Bonaparte rose through the French army until he was the general. He then joined a coup with a few other men, and they successfully overthrew the Directory. Napoleon now found himself the head consul and in charge of France. Napoleon was now the ruler over France, Italy, Prussia, Switzerland, and several islands. But Napoleon also helped to improve France. He wrote the Napoleonic Code, which made all French citizens equal before the law. However, women still had much less freedoms and rights. Napoleon also founded the Bank of France, which helped to stabilize the French economy. The Legion of Honor was also formed to reward brave soldiers. But then, Napoleon made a classic mistake. He invaded Russia. As Napoleon's Grand Army advanced, the Russians burned the countryside, leaving nothing for the 60,000-man army to eat in the harsh Russian winter. Most of Napoleon's men died, and he went back to Paris in shame. Then, to top it all off, the Russians, Austrians, and Prussians rebelled against Napoleon. He was then exiled to the island of Elba and stripped of his power. Somehow, Napoleon managed to escape the island and got troops to follow him. Napoleon attempted to relieve his glory during the Hundred Days. He raised a new army and began conquering again. However, it all ended at the Battle of Waterloo in Belgium. Napoleon was finally defeated. He was once again exiled to an island, where he spent the rest of his days. Was one of the greatest periods of change in European history. Machines, steam, and electricity replaced human working tools. This revolution created economic booms and new technology. However, working conditions were terrible, so labor unions began to form. The first big invention was in the textile industry. The inventor Paul Moody built carding, drawing, and roving machines. He then used a method called belting. These belts allowed faster speeds, and they were quieter. In the late 1770s, steam became the new energy source for factories instead of water. James Watt invented a steam-powered engine which changed the heat energy of steam into mechanical energy. This led to a boom in the coal and iron industry. Communication also changed drastically during the Industrial Revolution. Electric generators, telephones, and phonographs were invented. Arguably, one of the most important inventions was the light bulb. The Industrial Revolution revolutionized industry in Europe. The assembly line could now create many more products much more quickly. Also, social classes became very separate, with the proletariats as the poor, uneducated factory workers. The middle and upper class was the bourgeoisie, who were the factory owners. Working conditions in these mills were terrible. Workers were mangled and killed by machinery, didn't get sick pay, and even children had to work 16 hours a day. So labor unions formed to protect the workers. They organized strikes and negotiated the workers shorter hours and better working conditions.
I've been working so hard. I feel sick, but I still have 10 hours left in my shift.
I know what you mean, and people are being mangled and killed in machinery.
Even we have to work hard, and we're so small!
Soon, labor unions were created, and unions began picketing and negotiating for better rights for workers. Many countries in Western Europe wanted to extend voting rights. In 1832, the Reform Bill was passed, which extended voting rights to many middle-class men. Eventually, in the 1900s, even some women over the age of 30 were given voting rights. New ideas of social systems were also being created. One such idea was socialism. The socialists believed that all workers should get the same rewards for their labor. Robert Owen began treating his factory workers better and founded New Harmony, an experimental socialist community. Karl Marx also invented Marxism, which later became known as communism. He believed that the proletariat would rise against the bourgeoisie and cause revolutions, reshaping society. Romanticism also began. This movement was artistic. Romantic search for deeper subconscious appeals. The Industrial Revolution and the Napoleonic era changed the world drastically. Some awful things happened during these times, but they were historic.